So I'm running on very little sleep for the last two nights. Menopause has just decided to kick in the sleep department, depriving me of it. So today I need a moment for myself, and I thought I'm going to do a little self-care. And yesterday when I was putting my makeup on, I noticed that my skin was looking a little bit dehydrated, had a little bit of flaky skin. So that tells me I need to exfoliate today. And the other day I worked on my very first reel, which did not happen because I thought I had turned the camera off when I got on, and then when I came back, there was no camera. So I totally missed one whole segment. So, of course, I could not do the reel. But I did love the products that I was trying. And I had received, with an order from FreezeCo Beauty, three samples. And I thought, well, I'm going to try them. You know, I love samples, I never throw them out. It's how I have found some of the most fabulous products that I use. So these three in particular came from Osmosis, and there was the sunscreen. And you all know I have a very difficult time with sunscreen, so I'm always looking for sunscreens that do not irritate my skin. And then one was the cranberry enzyme mask. You know that I absolutely love enzyme masks. And I have always used the Sanitas cranberry mask and have loved it for years. But I thought, ooh, I'm going to try this. And then I think the name got me on this one until I opened the package and used it and said, oh my goodness, the tropical mango mask from Osmosis. And this is a barrier repair mask. And the enzyme, of course, is going to help exfoliate. And we all know what a sunscreen does. Anyway, after I was done with my first attempt of a reel, I loved these so much that I had to have the full sizes. So today I am going to do an actual video for you using both of these and a couple of other things. I'm just going to show you how I actually make myself feel better on days that I have had no sleep or I'm just feeling really run down. I firmly believe that every single human being needs to take that moment for themselves. And I don't care if it's just reading, it could be yoga, it could be listening to your most favorite music, it could be sitting down having coffee or tea. Just those few moments where you shut the world out and you just take care of you. So today, that's what I'm going to do. My doggy girls just came in from being outside. They're fed, they're happy. So they are in their crates because we're having some activity around the house and they will just bark the whole time. So this is their rest time too, which they absolutely love. And Lou is out golfing. So I have a couple of hours and I thought, well, I'll take about a half an hour to 45 minutes for myself. I have my lemon water here, and I don't think I've ever shared how I do my lemon water. I buy a huge bag of lemons and I juice them in my juicer, and then I pour the juice into my silicone trays, ice cube trays, and I freeze them so I don't lose any of the nutrients that come from juicing. And then I will fill this up with water, add some regular ice cubes, and then I will put two of the lemon ice cubes in here. And as the day goes on, the ice cubes just melt. And all day long, I have ice cold, because I prefer ice cold, lemon water. And we know that lemon water is refreshing. If I added sugar, I'd have a beautiful drink of lemonade. But that would defeat my purpose, wouldn't it? All right, so I'm going to get started. Now, right now, my skin, I have just washed it with my Truth Treatment Honey Cleanser, and it was just a gentle cleanse. It is morning, so I did not have any makeup on my skin when I started, so all I have done is cleanse. So I'm just going to take my hair and push it all back, and I'm going to put my headband on. You don't have to do this, but I just think it helps to keep the hair out of the way. Then you're not struggling with strands that might get stuck in the mask or the treatment. And because all of that is just going to annoy you. So we want this to be a stress-free treatment. All right, so I'm going to put nothing else on my skin, and we are going to go in with the Osmosis polish. I have been trying a lot of the Osmosis products. if you've been with me for a while, you know when menopause happened, and I am now postmenopausal. 57, I went through menopause, and I am now, I'm going to be 63 in November. Oh my goodness. Oof, where does the time go? Anyway, okay, so we are doing the polish enzyme. This is going to exfoliate. It infuses the skin with antioxidants. I think you will truly be able to see a difference when you look at my skin. Now, I don't have a lot of problem areas. This is to basically just really lift off any dead skin cells and prepare it for the hydrating, moisturizing mask that I'm going to use after. And I also have a couple of other little things here because, you know, I can never do just one thing. Never, never. All right, so this is for all skin types. It's for pigmented, dry, oily, blemish-prone skin. And it's on a clean face. Apply a thin layer and allow it to sit for 5 to 15 minutes. You know that CMT, you know that she leaves it on for the 15 minutes, all right? So, comes in a nice tube so you don't have to stick your fingers in a jar. And again, I also love the Sanitas. So I am just going to take a silicone applicator and I'm going to apply, I would say, about a dime's worth. And I'm just going to start applying it. You want to make sure that you really apply it to your areas that give you a hard time. It'll also help with the pores. So I'm going to be looking in a mirror straight ahead because I don't want to get any of this in my eye. And I can already feel the tingling sensation. That is normal with an enzyme and it is okay unless it is burning you. Then you remove it. So I'm just going to apply a thin layer all over. And that's what's nice about these silicone applicators. You just have to glide along with them. And it helps you to use the right amount of product. I think that a lot of us over apply when it's not necessary. So I'll just go ahead and put that on the side of my temple area. And notice I'm working down from my eyes. I do not put this around my eyes. And you really do need just a thin layer. It's very, I mean, I can feel this and it's really, I love the feel of it. So I'm going to go ahead and just put a little bit more on that silicone and apply it. And you're not, it doesn't matter if you go in a downward motion or an upward because you'll notice this silicone glides along the skin. It is not dragging on the skin. I'm going to take just another pea size. After your initial blob that you put on early, just go with pea size amounts because you really don't need to overuse this product. You can feel it working right away. All right, so just another pea size for my forehead, and I really do mean a pea size. And get in that T-zone area really well because most people, that's where they will have a lot of issues. If you're somebody who uses retinol products and you have a little bit of peeling, you don't want to overdo it with these, but you can use them to help lift that dead skin right off. I think enzymes are pure magic. I do. Just a little bit more on the forehead and I am all done there. And I am going to go ahead and put it on my neck. Now, the neck can be sensitive for some, so always do a little patch test. I don't have a problem. I'm going to use just about that much for my neck. And I'm going to go right underneath the jaw. And again, you see how I'm flattening that silicone? And it helps to just spread it exactly where you want it. And the silk robe that I'm wearing is from Silk and Pure. I don't know if I still have an active code for Silk and Pure, but I will surely find out. And if I do, it will be below. Okay, so that is all we need to do for the enzyme mask. They are very easy to use. They really, it's just a matter of applying and then leaving them sit. Now you will feel a tingling sensation. This is absolutely normal and you may feel it a little more, it may tingle a little more in certain areas and you may feel it a little bit more on your neck, but I do highly suggest that you do a test area to make sure that it's not going to burn you. Because if you're super sensitive, it may be too much for you. But for me, although my skin became very sensitive after menopause, I don't think I ever finished my thought there. After menopause, my skin became very, very sensitive and I could not use anything. And I am a skincare junkie, my friend. So this was very almost traumatizing for me. Not really, not really. But it really did take some of my joy away to not be able to use all the things I absolutely love. But I'd say probably about a month ago, I thought I really, really, really want to use a glycolic. I really want to use a glycolic product. So I did, and I had no problems. And I do really think, and I attribute it to the Truth Treatment System. Because Ben's treatment system is all about getting to the cell layer, really healing and repairing the skin. And I do think that by cutting out the L-ascorbic acid vitamin C, which was very irritating to my skin when postmenopausal hit, probably I'd say 2 years ago, just about 2 years ago, L-ascorbic acid became an issue for me. So I then, when I changed over to the Truth Treatment, I really feel that that vitamin C, the THD, I think, I said very long name, but I know it's a fat soluble vitamin C. And Ben's products are made with absolutely no water. And his vitamin C and all of his products actually are for cell. He wants to get it deep into your cell. So yeah. I do attribute my skin healing to Truth Treatment. So I'm always going to use Truth Treatment. I incorporate it with the Osmosis that I've recently purchased, and you know, we're going to see how it all works. But you know me, I play around with everything so that I can bring you all options. All right. So we're just going to leave this sit and then I will be back and we'll remove it and move on. Okay. So we are back and it has been about 15 minutes and I wanted you to see how it dries down. It is tacky. You can see it's sticking onto my fingers when it dries down. So I have some warm washcloth here. Of course, if you're at your sink or you're in your shower, you just rinse it off. I'm just going to lay the warm cloth on for a second just to help soften it. And then I will just start wiping away. Easier if you're at your sink. And then we'll just go up the neck. Mask is off now, and I think you can see a big difference in the skin. It just looks really fresh, and any redness you see is not from the mask. It's from me wiping with a washcloth. My skin does get red when I rub on it. Okay, so next I am going to go in with the cream mask, but before I put the cream mask on, I'm going to go ahead and put an eye mask on, and I'm going to be using the Dermatology Brightening Eye Mask. I've been using these for a little while now. I do like some of the Dermatology products. So I'm gonna go in, the mask looks like this, and I'm just gonna take a little spoon and take one of the mask, and these do have a lot of solution, and I'm just going to apply it underneath my eye, and I try to get up as close to the lash line as I can. And then I'll go ahead and use one more. You can use any eye mask that you have. You can even use the avocado mask right up underneath your eye, but I like to do both when I am really feeling the love. Okay, so that is it for the eye mask, and this will stay on as long as the avocado mask or longer, it doesn't matter. Again, those are the Dermatology, and I do think I have a code to save on these. I think it's still active, so that'll be underneath for you if I do. Okay, so these should stay in place. Usually they do. Now I'm going to go in with the Tropical Mango Barrier Repair Mask. And this can be used every single day. And the enzyme can be used 1 to 3 times a week. Go do the enzyme according to your skin. Now I can handle 1 to 3 times a week. I can do 3 times a week. But not everybody will be able to. So really listen to your skin and look at it when you're done. And now this mask here is for aging sensitive, irritated, dry skin. And like I said, it can be used every single day. And it also stays on for 5 to 15 minutes. How long is crazy, Miss Tammy, gonna leave it on? This is what the mask looks like. It does smell like, it smells wonderful, like mangoes, but this is the consistency. Now I'm going to go in with the spoon and just take a little bit out to begin with. And again, I'm going to use a silicone applicator. And I'm going to go all the way around the eye mask. And again, if you lay that silicone on its side, you get most of your mask. You get the best application. This really smells wonderful. And I couldn't believe the sample when I used it. I said, this is a fabulous mask. And I'm just going to apply it everywhere that I have skin. Right up around that eye mask. Go up the temple. And if this is a day that you're going to wash your hair, don't worry about getting it in your hair. Just go up and around. All right, so I'm going to take a little bit more. The mango mask is on. I'm going to go in with my Revitalsh. This is the Lash and Brow Mask. Yes, I even have a mask for that. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put it on my eyelashes. This really has conditioned my lashes nicely. I don't know about you, but I'm getting those as white as my hair is. That's how white my lashes want to be. And this has really conditioned them because white hair can be very stubborn. So I've been really enjoying this. And again, you just put it on and allow it to dry and then you remove it. It does take a little effort to remove, but nothing that's going to damage your lashes or your eyes. You just have to set a warm cloth on them for a little bit. And I did go over with the mango mask, but I'm gonna just go ahead and really get in between each eyebrow. I should have probably avoided my eyebrows for doing this, but that's okay. So instead of just sticking it back in there, I'm going to just wipe it off so I don't get the mango mask in there. Okay, easy. All right, and I'm just gonna leave this sit. Now this mask can stay on 5 to 15 minutes, and you can just simply sit with it if that's what you'd like. But, you know, that's not what I'm gonna do. I have my handy dandy little vibrating tool, which I really like. And I'm just going to, this mask is sliding down just slightly. So I'm gonna just hold that vibrator over this mask for a few minutes. Now normally I will hold my mask and I just kind of move out because I'm working on drainage when I'm using this tool. You can do this with or without your eye mask. It doesn't matter, but I like to do a little bit of everything. And I don't know, I tell myself I'm really pushing the solution in. You just have to be a little careful because these masks are a little on the fragile side. You don't have to do this tool at all, but I have a lot of puffiness underneath my eyes, so I like to just give it a little once over. And that would be it, okay? So now there are other things you can do with this mask. Now, I think that this is back ordered. I have some, I can't remember what these are called, but I have them. I'm drawing a blank right now, but they're ice cold and you do a massage with them. And these are fabulous. You can get these from other companies or Biolique Rigiaires has them. But Osmosis has what they call their cool skin tool. Now theirs looks like this. And you just keep it in the refrigerator. I have a bowl of ice water here to keep them cold, but this does stay cool, I believe for like 60 minutes. I can't remember what it said, but it says the Cool Skin Tool is designed to cool, soothe, and help stimulate blood circulation to ease inflammation, irritation, and redness. So if you are someone who has inflammation or maybe even rosacea, you might want to try a tool like this. It says enhance your skincare routine as it tightens pores and diminishes the appearance of fine lines by aiding your product ingredients to penetrate deeper for faster, more effective results. So what I like to do is when I have a mask like this on, I will sometimes just massage over the mask, and it usually has a good slip. It all depends on the mask you have on, but just to go over your skin like this, oh, if you have a sunburn, oh, this would be fabulous. But I'm just massaging that mango mask with the tool. Go right over your lip. It feels fabulous. You can do like a massage with it. It's really lovely. Really lovely. You can go in circular motions, or you can just go in strokes over your nose to really address the pore situation. Again, it's going to glide easier depending on the mask you are using. And then it'll go up on the forehead. Really, really nice. That is the cooling tool from Osmosis, but like I said, I think it's back ordered for a little while, as is their avocado oil, which is fabulous, fabulous, fabulous. But I did talk to Freeze Co Beauty, and she is on it. As soon as they are back in stock, she will definitely let us know. Now, if you have these tools, because I've talked about these in the past, and I've actually used them during some of my facials many, many years ago. I've been using these for years. You can just massage along. You can just massage along your skin with these. Move up and down, again, on your face. Just a light motion. On your forehead. It's just very relaxing. But again, there are some benefits to this. You can go right over your eyes and just hold them. So if you have puffiness, if you're someone who gets headaches, this would be a really beautiful tool for you to own. You can just lay them over the eyelids. You can use them over your mask. Now the masks get a little tricky because they could lift them up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually take the mask off right now, the eye mask, and show you how I would use these over my eyes. So you can just go over the eyes with this in a nice sweeping motion. This will help with puffiness. You can go right over. Just massage the eye area very gently and lightly. Sweep right over the actual eye. On the temple area. And all the way down to the neck area. And you can do this for a couple of minutes, or you can do it the whole time the mask is on, 15 minutes, and just keep moving in a gentle motion along the temples, around the mouth, over the lip area, through the T-zone area, around the eyes, along the cheek. I know for me, this really helps. I have a lot of inflammation in the jaw area because of my TMJ, and this really does help to just relieve all that. And then I'll use moist heat sometimes and just alternate them. Really, really, I love the cooling tools. Now, if you're using the Osmosis, some of you may already have this. You can just go up underneath the eye, just back and forth. And you will see the difference. It kind of emulsifies the mask as well, but that's fine. It's still on your skin. It's still working. Same on the other side. Beautiful. Love, love, love these. And then over the T-zone area, the nose area, back and forth, long strokes up and under the cheekbone, over the other side. Whatever you do to one side, do to the other side. And then of course you can go right over the mouth. Of course the neck area, under the jaw, really just to help tighten and firm that area up. You get the gist, right? All right, so now I'm just going to allow this to sit for the rest of the time and remove it. And I think you are going to see that my skin surely has come alive from the beginning of the video. And I think you can also tell just by taking this little bit of time, it's boosted my own mood. All right, so I'm gonna take a little lemon water and let this mask sit for the rest of the time and I will be right back. Okay, I'm back. It's been about 20 minutes, so I'm just going to take a warm cloth. I'm gonna lay it over the mango mask. Of course, if you're in the shower or you're at your sink, you're going to wash this off at the sink. And you just wanna make sure that you really remove all of the mask. You don't have to use a cleanser afterwards, but you do have to make sure that you have removed most of the mask, or all of the mask, I should say. Go along your jawline. Up on the sides. I have a couple of washcloths here that I'm gonna go ahead. I have a clean one now. I have to tell you, I wash all my whites that I'm going to use in my facials. I wash them with essential oils, lavender. They smell fabulous. All right, so just one last sweep and you are going to see that this skin, I'm gonna take that mask off my eyebrows and then go over my lashes. All right, and there you have it. While your skin is still wet, you want to go in with your skincare treatment. So I'm going to go ahead and show you what I am using right now. First, I'm going to go in with my Osmosis Stemfactor. This is their growth factor serum. I do one, not even a full pump, and I massage it onto my fingers and I tap it all over and then I go down my neck and I apply. I will go right up underneath my eyes with this. Now, if I weren't using this and I was using the Neogenesis, of course I would use the Neogenesis eye serum. So now I'm going to go ahead and put my Rescue from Osmosis. Just a small amount of this as well. Pat it on all over. And now with Osmosis, there is an activator. So I'm going to go ahead and use that. It's the Boost. I just spray it over the face. It's a fine mist and then massage it in. And this activates the stem factor. So now I'm going to put on my vitamin C. Now there, I do have the vitamin C with Osmosis, but I'm kind of alternating because one is L-ascorbic and then of course there's the Truth treatment. For me, I want the benefits of both. And L-ascorbic is great at brightening, but for me, the Truth treatment serum, I just really feel it has changed my skin totally. So I'm going to do my trifecta, which is my vitamin C, and I do three drops. That was four, one snuck out on me. And then I am going to take my hyaluronic acid, which I think I'm just about out of. Yep. I usually only have to do one squirt, but because I'm almost out of it, the squirt is very small. And then I'm going to take my biomimetic mineral mist and take three pumps and massage that together and apply that all over my face, neck, and I love it. Now, if I were using the Osmosis vitamin C, I would have used the Stemfactor, the vitamin C, the Rescue, and then I would have spritzed the Osmosis Boost over it to help activate it. So that is all I'm going to do for that until I do my moisturizer. But I did get the Osmosis Refresh Revitalizing Eye Cream. So I'm going to go ahead, and this is in one of these little wand type, and I will just put a little bit of that around on each eye. And you need very little, you don't need a lot. And then you just kind of massage it in with the applicator. This is a very nice applicator. If you don't like using applicators, you don't have to. You can just go and tap your eye cream all the way around, top and bottom. Nice. And again, you can use the applicator, but if you don't want to, just tap it all around. And last but not least is my moisturizer, and I'm going to use the Osmosis MD Quench. And you need a very small amount of this. I mean, really, that's plenty. And I'm gonna go ahead and just tap this all over. It smells really nice, like oranges to me. Okay, so that is before the sunscreen. Look how nice the skin looks. It really does look great. I think the combination of the cool and the mask really does plump the skin up. It made the texture look really fabulous. That enzyme mask is superb. Final step is the sunscreen, and this is the Protect. I had a sample of it, and my skin was not irritated by it. I think there's some left in there here. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply this to my face. I'm just gonna go ahead and pat it all over, down the neck, and of course you'll do the chest, but for my chest I use something different, but for my neck I do use, I have about four sunscreens now that I have found that I can really use. And here in Florida, I definitely need it. All right, and go over the eyelids with it. And I find that this plays well with my makeup. I go right up underneath my eyes with it. Eyelids, brows, everywhere. And of course, the ears. And that is it for today's self-care routine, my friends. It really does help to make a difference. It has energized me. It has made me feel better, even though I am existing on very few hours of sleep. It was just one of those nights. I don't have many of them. It really has calmed down for me, but last night and the night before were brutal. So I just felt today I needed to take a little bit of time for me. And I honestly, when I use these, I really wanted to do my first reel, but you know, it didn't work out. But once I used those samples, I was like, oh my goodness, I'm in love. I love this cranberry enzyme and the tropical mango mask. To be honest with you, I'm really enjoying the Osmosis MD line. So stay tuned for more updates on the Osmosis skincare and how my skin is responding to it. So I will list and link everything underneath this video. If I have a code for it, it will also be underneath. Of course, I do have a code for the Osmosis and the Truth, because I get them all at Frisco Beauty, and she gives us 20% off. Tammy20 is the code. And like I said, I think I have one for dermatology. I have to check on that. So it will be below the video for you. And yeah, that's it for today. So before you leave, if you have not already subscribed, I would love to have you as an Ageless Beauty. Hit the subscribe button right there, and right next to it is the bell that'll notify you of all the videos that I'm putting out. Until the next time, my friends, you go out in the world and be lovable. And don't forget, it is okay to love your age. I love you all. Bisous.